tonight we have got the mother of all Fridays, as in 4 hours, 34 minutes, three new housemates are going to be going in there.
Oh, my
in
God.
That house. And you guys are going to get to meet them first on this very show. How amazing is that?
How amazing is that, indeed?
I'm really excited.
However, before our new housemates enter, one must leave. This week, it's the Battle of the Boys as the man with the mega monobrow takes on our pouting Aussie.
Also on today's show, we'll be talking to the lady who is to Fridays what fake tan is to Corin. Stavina McCall.
Yeah. And she's more atomic in the kitchen than Nathan. Liz McLaren's here, everybody.
So back to last night's show. Titan the robot is still battling the housemates for global supremacy. And he must be quaking in his titanium sockets, facing a monk, an orange northerner, and a lazy top. Here is what happened, Toph. Stop messing with my hair, George.
Oh my God.
Oh. I am Titan. Robots are now in control of the Big Brother house.
How's it going?
Man is victorious.
My job as a Christian is to manifest the love of God in such a way that people encounter God.
This is where I think it's hypocritical.
And this is what I don't talk about.
Let's appreciate we have different views.
The atmosphere of the house has been brilliant. I'm not going down that road.
You expect me to share all my things with you?
There are more and more things I'm beginning to dislike about you each day. By the end of the week, I could quite possibly despise you.
I don't speak like that, then.
He's quite boring.
Which housemate would you like to replace for Titan?
Yeah, let's replace him with Ben.
From Ben about Mario's love for robots. I think so. Now, Josie and Corin may have been beaten by Titan, but I think there's one lady who could easily take on a 7'3" robot. Davina McCall could! Come on!
Seriously, now feel my heart.
It's beating really fast. Is that about what's happening tonight or about the robot?
I hate it, isn't it? I hate it.
But how amazing to have it in the house for, you know, a whole day. It was brilliant.
I don't know how they did it. I feel sick. I don't even want to go anywhere near it.
Well, you've got to in a minute.
Okay.
I'll explain that in a second. But let's talk about tonight. New housemates are going in there.
Yes.
We obviously know a little bit, but what do you know that we don't?
I do know things, but I'm not sure how much I'm allowed to tell you.
Just tell us. I won't tell anyone.
I could tell you that... I'm not sure whether I'm allowed to tell you if it's there is one boy and two girls.
Yes, yes, she can tell us that, can't she? Yes, this man's going, told ya. So this week, Big Brobot, he took over the house.
Yes.
If you had to fight Titan, what would you have done to conquer him?
I think cheating is quite a good idea, basically, because he's quite clumsy.
Yeah.
Just really frightens me. I think
push him over, maybe.
Yeah, no, or just sort of shiftily. His sort of vision doesn't seem too good, so I might shiftily just try and sort of steal something off him. And
okay, well, do you know what?
He's a bit clumsy as well. Big old robot hands.
He is clumsy.
He doesn't know what to
do
with himself.
He wasn't very good with the
making smoothies,
was he?
He's not good with little things, is he? So I'd try and get him to do something
little. He had trouble with grapes. Do you know what, Davina?
He did. Grapes as well.
We're going to find out, because you're about to go head to helmet with the beast himself. Don't make me drag you. Davina, this is Titan. We've got some of Titan's stats, Davina. Come and see what you're up against. Right, Titan is 7'3". He's got multiple personalities. He's got man-crushing hands. And he really likes to battle humans.
I'm crying. Oh, my God.
Titan, this is Davina. Come back. Davina, come meet Titan. Right, Davina, your stats are up. You're 5'7". You've had 5 fitness DVDs. These abs are made of steel, so you better be careful. And she's got multiple presenting skills. Come stand this side. So say hello very quickly.
Oh,
you've got to stand a little bit closer.
I can't.
Right, this is what's going to happen.
I can't.
Right, you've both
I'll
got,
do it from
you've
here.
Both got 30 seconds. To cut off as much of Dave's hair. Oh, it doesn't move. You're going to have to go over there.
So
as possible. Are you both ready? Pick up your tools.
Look, I'm quite...
Right, can we get 30 seconds on the clock? And as soon as the klaxon goes, start. Cut!
You're
go on,
Dave.
He's talking to you as well
now.
Go on, Dave. Oh, you've taken a big... Drop your scissors.
10,456.
Right, okay, time is up. Scissors down, clippers down. Come on, Titan, stop cheating. Right, let's bring in our adjudicator, Liz McLarnon. Liz, coming in. She's really glamorous and knows about things like this. Liz, who would you
You're
say won? Don't stand behind me!
I don't want to annoy him because he's very scary and big.
But Davina quite clearly won, didn't she?
Yeah. She did! She took a big chance.
Big right, robot
well
has
done,
been
Davina.
That
congratulations.
Man is
Titan.
Victorious.
Let's hear it for Titan, Davina. Yeah. Right, as we all know, three new housemates are going into the house. Earlier on today, I had the privilege of speaking to them. Not even Davina's done that yet.
Oh.
Sorry. Oh, for the first time ever on television, here is housemate
number one.
It's housemate number one, Keely. Who are you?
Keely. Oh, sorry. I'm Keely. I'm from Manchester. I'm 31 this year, and I manage travel agents.
Who's going to drive you crazy? Kiva. You've encountered Kiva before?
Yeah, she was stood right at the side of me when we were waiting to go in. Right. I was trying to make little chit-chat conversation with her. She was ignorant. She was just like... First impressions last with me.
Yes.
And I've watched her in the house, and she's just as arrogant as she was stood next to me. Yeah,
Kiva. So there could be fireworks with
possibly,
you and Kiva.
Possibly, yeah.
So, that was housemate number one. Keep watching for Emma's exclusive interviews with housemates number two and number three later in the show. So tonight we're going to be losing either our northern monkey Nathan or our Aussie hunk JJ. It's the monobrow versus the Melbourne. Yes. In the Nathan camp, we've got his best friend Marcus and Auntie Lorraine. Hello, Marcus and Auntie Lorraine. And for Spunky John James, we've got his first love. We've got his mum, Helena. Obviously, Helena lives in Melbourne. It's 3 a.m. in the morning. You all right, Helena? Are you there, my love?
Yes, I'm from.
Very good.
I'm here. How are you?
I'm all right, Princess. John James is up for eviction. First time up. Are you surprised?
Not really.
No.
He's been overbearing, hasn't he?
He's been a proper pain in the backside, hasn't he, Helena?
He has.
Does he have such a bad temper when he's at home with you?
Oh, he has his moments, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And what about that kiss with Josie? Huh? Have you seen it?
Yeah, I have, but... Did they actually kiss, though?
Not really.
No, I didn't think so. The picture that we've got, they didn't actually connect.
Would you like it if he brought Josie back to you? To Melbourne?
I would, yes. I don't think she'd like it here, though.
All right, Helena. Thank you, my love. Take care. Good luck. And let's go to Nathan C. Marcus. Oh, now, on last night's show, your boy said that he really liked hanging out with Ben and... Who did he say he liked hanging out with? Ben and Dave, yeah. Does he usually hang out with guys like that?
Not usually, as a rule of thumb, but...
Would you like to hang out with Ben and Dave?
Oh, anytime, yeah.
Yeah? Okay. And what about you, Auntie Lorraine? You've obviously known him all his life. Is he being the real Nathan in there?
Generally, no.
Really?
We actually feel he's got nobody to bounce off.
Right, OK.
He's nicknamed the Giant Tigger at home.
Right, so he's actually been a bit more subdued?
Definitely.
All right, guys, well, listen, good luck to you two, both teams tonight. Give them a big round of applause. It's going to be a close one tonight. Now, each week, the eviction crowd gets longer and longer, people queuing up for out. Hang on a minute. What are you doing here, Shabby?
She's going in.
I'm here on a little campaign, aren't I?
Get Shabby in. What's all this? I know you said you regretted leaving the house, but what's all this about? Quiet down.
I'm just kind of hoping that I might be able to get back in there to help give her a little thing or two.
Yeah. Really? Mm. Oh, it's got like that, has it?
It has.
And I believe you've got a Facebook petition?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, 700 members right now, huh? Imagine how many are going to be on there at the end of this show. Let's have a little look at Shabby's campaign so far.
Big Brother, this is Shabby Catchadurian. I'm going to prove to you that maybe the public might still want me in. I mean, doesn't everybody deserve a second chance? So I say, get Shabby in!
Even though she had her tantrums, it was like fun to watch. So she should go back in.
We've got to get Shabby back in, and then there can be some more traumas and some more action.
She's fantastic. Please, stick her back.
Back in.
I feel like a politician.
We want to get Shabby back in. Expert.
No, expert.
I'm Big Brother.
Get Shabby in the house. Get Shabby in the house. She ain't quite like a mouse. She goes throwing pillows everywhere. Yeah. You never see her weep like a willow. But maybe you do, but she goes real quick. Yeah. Shabby.
Get me back in.
Hats off to you, Shabby. But once you're out, really, my love. Walkers, eh? They always live to regret it. Coming up, we'll be getting catty with Liz McClan and see what we did there. And we'll be meeting two more brand spanking housemates. Hey, Titan. Titan, oi! Titan, it's not going to work with you up here, mate. This is Davina's stage. No. This is
the lines are closed. The votes have been counted and verified.
Oh, gonna. He thinks he's Davina. Come on, don't push me, Titan. Don't push me. Yeah, really? How about now? Anyway, Nathan and John James are up for eviction, but who goes? It's up to you. Here are the numbers to dial. See you in four.
To evict John James, call 09011 323 007. To evict Nathan, call 09011 323 010. Calls cost 50p from a BT landline, other networks may be higher, and mobiles will cost considerably more. 15p from each call will be donated to charity. Details and terms at channel4.com/Big Brother. Voting closes later tonight.
Welcome back to Little Brother. It's 18-18. Now, Titan may have terrified the housemates this week, but you don't have to worry. I will not let any robot gatecrash BBLB, especially not on
Eviction Friday.
Sorry, I don't know what happened there. I'll try again. Eviction Friday. Oh, right, in just over 4 hours, we'll be finding out if Nathan or John James will be breathing the bittersweet air of freedom later tonight. And, of course, we'll have three new housemates going into the house. Yeah! So, if you're ready, let's check out housemate number two.
Housemate number two. Right, who are you? Tell me a bit about you.
My name's Rachel. I work for a very famous low-budget airline. I just moved into this little cozy little flat, and I was made up because I bought this rug. It was £20, reduced to £15, and I was just admiring my rug. Then I got the call private number, so I didn't expect it to be anything than, like, the landlord or the electricity or the meter, yeah. And I heard, hi, is that Rachel? I was like, ah!
And she said, Big Brother wants you.
Oh, my God, he picked me! The roaming eye.
I can't wait to see you. Rachel, thank you so much.
Oh, thanks, Emma.
What do we reckon to Rachel, guys? Do we like her? Still got another housemate to meet. In the meantime, though, Willis, where are you, babe? I want to hear some news.
Can do. Yesterday at 12:13, an argument that started off as a pop at Ben for not pulling his weight in a kitchen, surprise, surprise, turned into a full-blown Big Brother row. Topic of conversation? World War II, of course.
Your first loyalty has to be to those countries that are under the Queen with the same head of state. That's the way it works.
Thousands and thousands of Englishmen went to war in Germany, France and all over Europe and died and gave their lives so you could sit there, pompous. As far as I'm concerned, you're insulting my granddad.
Why?
Me, my forefathers, all the people who died during war because you're talking out your arse.
Oh, that told him Ben is never, ever going to learn how to keep his opinions to himself. Then at 7 o'clock last night, man versus machine came to a head in an epic final battle. Housemates against one of Big Robot's deadliest minions, Bigger Brother. No guesses for guessing who won.
That's not very nice.
He's taking off. Whoa! Oh, he's kicking my car!
Bigger Brother is victorious, and housemates have failed this week's shopping task.
Titan, are we still going out on that date?
Affirmative.
Yeah!
Yes! It's chickpeas all week! I love it! Finally, you might have wondered what has been going on with our third housemate to be evicted, Sunshine. Well, she spent the week up to her gargoyles shooting a pop video with Rachel. And here is a very special behind-the-scenes preview just for you.
And you had a dance routine, which the director just didn't think we were living up to it.
Is it good enough? Go on!
Where the hell is Lady Gaga? She's taking her time getting ready. I've been ready and waiting. I mean, Beyonce would never put up with this, so why should I?
If you want to see even more behind-the-scenes footage, go to channel4.com/Big Brother later on tonight. Plus, the entire video will be played tonight on Big Mouth at 11:20 on E4. But look who's with us! Sunshine's here over there! How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Yes. Now, Sunshine, a week ago today, you got the boot from the Big Brother house.
I did.
3 days later, Shabby walked, kind of stole your thunder a little bit.
I don't think she did it on purpose. I think she just felt she really had to go.
Were you a little bit gutted, though, that she
did? I was gutted to leave.
Well, obviously,
I want to go back in.
Well, you can't go back in. But were you gutted that she kind of walked and stole your thunder this week?
No, I think, yeah, I like her. So I like sharing it with her.
What have you been doing? What have you been up to?
Well, we did that really cool video.
I can't wait to see that tonight.
Yeah, I can't either. Bits and bobs for this. I've been trying to respond to all the lovely messages. Twitter, Sunshine Martin, Martin with a Y.
Oh, let's just pick that up off the floor and give it back to you.
But yeah, I'm trying to respond to everybody. I'm loving that. And also, I got my grade for my degree that I've done this year.
Which was?
A first.
Woo! Well done, Sunshine. Thank you so much. Now, Sunshine's pop video will be performed tonight on Big Mouth. That's right, isn't it? Fantastic. Can't wait. Thank you, Sunshine. It's like revolving doors here today. One goes, another one comes. It's time now, though, for our final housemate. I met him earlier, and this is what happened. Look who I've got. It's housemate number three. Now, I know your name is Andrew.
That's right, yeah.
But tell me more.
I'm 19. Yes. I'm a student. I study mathematics.
Yes.
At Oxford.
Who do you think you'll get on with the best in the house?
I like Mario and Corinne as well. She seems really bubbly.
Very sweet girl.
Very sweet, yeah.
Do you fancy her a little bit?
A little bit of a crush. Bit of an older woman, though, so.
Enjoy it. It's going to be amazing.
Going to go off tonight and now. Not only was our next guest part of one of Britain's biggest girl bands, she also presents her own show called Hotter Than My Daughter, something I like the sound of. It's Liz McClarnon, everybody. How are we doing? Liz, welcome. Liz, I understand... Calm yourselves. Liz, I understand you actually know one of the housemates, Iffy, right? You've met her a couple of times.
I've met her a few times. I don't know her, but she seems really nice.
Yeah? Is she the same Iffy you've met, the one that we're seeing inside?
Exactly the same. That's why I think she's not really getting stuck into things very much.
Really? Mm. Right, she's too nice.
Too nice.
Too nice.
Right? But I think she'll stand up to people. Do you know what I mean?
Okay, well, she stood up to Kiva and Duda, didn't she? Right, now, another big story this week. Everybody's turning on Corinne, it would seem.
Which I hate. I
know
love
you
Corinne.
Like Corinne, but we've got an exclusive clip from tonight, so this is JJ doing a Corinne impersonation.
Oh my God, have you got half a bottle of water? Oh my God.
Shut up, John, do better.
Mario, your hair is different today. Oh my God. Oh my God, your hair
John
is looking different. Are you loving it? Are you loving it? Are you buzzing?
Are you loving a bitch.
Are you loving your hair?
Shut your mouth.
Oh. Do you think Corinne's fake?
No, not at all.
No.
And actually, JJ, it's not like that, is it? Oh, my God!
Right,
more like that.
Yeah.
Oh, it's
Liz, we know you you walked through MasterChef or Celebrity MasterChef. If you were making the perfect recipe for the perfect housemate, what would you put in there?
Well, I've just said that he was wrong, but he is quite fit. JJ's body. Right, I think.
Okay, so you'd have some of JJ's body in there. Yeah.
And actually, the basis of the face, but definitely Mario's eyes.
Yeah.
Ben's lips, because he's got great lips.
He's got good lips. Yeah. He has got good lips, actually. Quite pouty, yeah?
Oh, yeah, exactly.
He looks a bit like Vern Troyer, actually.
Oh, it's a bit scary. It looks like The Rock.
Yeah, it's not so good. We're the only people who can see this out here. Anyway, it looks nice. It looks real nice. Now, there's three housemates in there. What do we think, kind of ingredients-wise, we need out of those guys? What have they got to be like?
I think they've got to be... I think we need a hot girl. I think we need someone to... Someone to stand up to Dave a bit. He's
really?
Doing a little bit, yeah.
Really? Do we like Dave, guys?
No!
Not so much, now, I can tell you, over the last couple of days, the housemates have eaten gourmet dishes such as chips and beans. Yeah, real nice. And some mince and mash.
Oh, that's nicer.
And nothing else very nice. If Nathan goes out, who's gonna cook? Who's going to jump into the kitchen?
I have no idea. I wouldn't know, but he's got to go.
Really? You think it's going to be Nathan?
Yeah,
all right, Dan, give him a big round of applause. Liz McCarthy. That's it for now, guys. Big thank you to all our guests, especially Titan. Don't miss the Lara Eviction show tonight at 9 p.m. when either Nathan or JJ will bite Big Brother dust. And don't forget, you can find out even more about how our new housemates are going into dust. Channel4.com/Big Brother.
And don't forget to join us on Sunday, Channel 4, at the slightly earlier time of 11:15, where we'll be talking to everyone's favourite wag, Nicola T.
And Mayhem's Geraldine Jigga Dag will be here. Take care. Bye.